may seem strange that any man should dare to ask a just God's assistance in wringing their bread from the sweat of other men's faces.
He's saying, how can you even believe that it's okay to enslave other persons and benefit from their labor without any benefit to them? All of that is framed in religious language and his understanding of God and what God's worth is.
The war goes so far beyond the suffering. It gets so profound and deep, and you're forced to come to grips of what in the world is this all about? At first, it sort of alienated him to God, but as he went through the suffering and the death and the incredible profundity of the war, it makes him more spiritual.
The prayers of both could not be answered. That of neither has been answered fully.
People were coming to him, ministers and politicians, to say God is on our side. But he knew people were coming to Jefferson Davis to say God is on our side.
He's using the language of Christianity to shift the Southern consciousness about what this war meant.
It is a presidential inaugural address during a time of war to talk about bringing the nation together, while also saying that the thing that has rended the nation is something that Lincoln disagrees with.
The war ain't over yet, and yet it's close. The 13th Amendment has made it through Congress. He's got to bring about reestablishment of the total Union so as not to have Southern generals' heads sitting on pikes, as he would put it.
When you think about the original founding fathers, they founded a remarkable set of institutions based on self-governance and the equality of all human beings. But they found it with a birth defect of slavery. And so in many ways, Abraham Lincoln was the beginning of the second founding of the country to erase the scourge of slavery, which could never have really been consistent with the brave ideals that were put forth in the Declaration of Independence or the Constitution.
Both read the same Bible and pray to the same God, and each invokes his aid against the other.
This is where he does well to appeal to this Christocentric consciousness that was pervasive in the land. Even among Christian slaveholders who still felt justified holding people of African descent in bondage.
Yes, Lincoln is a 19th century person. He can't help us with climate change. But somehow he's one of those key people who I think speaks across time.
We are still bound by we the people, bound by the notions that are being exclaimed and articulated by Lincoln on that day in 1865.